Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, we're going to see how to transform Excel data using a Power Query editor. If your source system or you are having a data in Excel or any CSV files, then you need to do certain transformations before it fit into Power BI. Basically, the data in Excel won't be in a proper format. You have some headers at the top, or in between you have some rows, and you need to do some unpivoting. Those options you need to do before it suits for the reporting. Let us try to explore some of the basic transformation that most of the Excel sources will have. If you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button right now to learn the concepts in Power BI. So these are some of the common transformations. This is very simple, but to follow the flow, I'm retaking these small transformations. Usually you'll have end up with some of the header rows. You need to remove it, and then you need to promote some of the columns as headers. Then there will be some gaps filled up and down option will be used. Obviously you need to do the change of data type. If it is a time or date calculations to work, you need to set the date field as date data type. Then there is something like unpivoting. So these are the things we are going to see in this video. Let us try to see the data and what scenarios you will have to use these options. So as I said before, Excel is not straightforward. It's not having a structured data. Sometimes most of the people won't maintain properly. So they have some headers. It is not, we cannot say it's proper, because to have a proper understanding in the Excel, this is fits good in Excel, but not for reporting, right? So that is what I want to make. Now I want to remove these two rows to have these data to be in my report. So for that, I need to remove top n rows. And in this case, like I have a category and item, most of the people don't want to fill again and again. That creates readability of this Excel difficult. So they maintain like this. So this jeans denim also belongs to casual wear. So how you can handle this? But as a reporting tool, it will process row by row. Okay, so if this row is considered as null, so you need to fill this one before it go to the Power BI reporting purpose. So that is what, so we can do it in Power Query editor. In this case, you will try to edit or split some columns that I have did it in tips and tricks. You can watch that video. I'm not focusing on this today. And the data over here is like a budget for each location. As you might aware, we are understanding the Power BI for a business scenario, government business. He has three locations, and for these locations he is allocating some budget monthly, okay, and he is using this data over here. And what is the exact issue using this data? If you have a data like that, what is the difficulty in analyzing? Let me explain it in next video. For now, what I'm going to do is I will take this data and I will convert all these things into single column. That is, Chennai, Bangalore, Hyderabad location will be here. And here I will have month. Month column will have January, February, March, and the amount will be here. So I will convert this into three columns. Why we need to do it? Let us see it in my next video. But to convert this columns into rows is called unpivoting. Without wasting time, let us try to jump into a demo. I have this Power BI now. Let us try to get this data. So let me load all these four. Let me not load the customer info. So each table requires some kind of transformation. So I need to go for transform data. Let us go for it. Okay, now we got these three tables. Let us try to transform the first table, the data table. As we seen in the Excel, we got some top rows to be removed. Then only these rows can be usable. Now you see the data type for these columns also text, since it cannot detect right now what is the data underneath. It's try to sense from the top rows, and everything is considered as your text, right? Whereas for this also, so you see here it is dated, but it doesn't detect it because it contains all combination. It contains text, it contains some number, it contains date, so it got confused. Okay, so first thing is like we need to remove this row. Okay, and for that, remove rows. Okay, remove top rows. How many rows you want to delete? One. Okay, you might have asked me why it is one, because here I need to remove two rows. So Power BI by default, if this is merged columns, so by default the first column, this column is considered as a column header. So this Naga garments went into header name, other columns are empty since it is matched. Okay, that is the thing. So if it is not matched, then this only came to, I mean it went to that column header, then these things will have some other columns. Forget about that. Now right now you just see how it has read the data. I need to remove one rows in this case, so just mention one here. That's it. Now what you need to do is, after you remove the unnecessary rows, then you need to promote it as it is. So this one, this is the option for to promote all this row, first row as header. Use first row as header, and you can see it here for each action I did, removing first row, removing promoting the first row as header, everything comes as an action here. This is very important thing you need to understand. Now right from the first step, how I navigated, all these things are getting recorded. You can delete any one of the step in between, or you can move the step. So it is so powerful in this case, the Power Query Editor. Let's try to navigate it. So this source is nothing but I pointed to that Excel, and from there what I am doing, I'm navigating is nothing but I'm choosing the particular sheet. This is navigating. Then what I did, the Power BI itself will promote all the rows as header. Okay, that is what it, as I said, this particular row it has read and it has promoted as an header. So it, this is the step for that. Then it has changed the data type. Like if you see here in promotion, promoted headers, you can see the ABC 1 2 3, meaning it can have a text or numbers. Whereas in change data type, it converts everything as a text. Then these are the custom transformations we did. We removed top rows, then promoted as headers. If I don't want this step, what happens? I'm removing this step. Just click on this cross. Then I promoted first row as header, right? Then that step is deleted. So I can roll back to my previous stage. If I delete those two steps, then I can revert to this particular state. That is, in this state, I don't have the column headers. So I can go back to the steps. This is somewhat very powerful when you are troubleshooting or creating your transforming your data. Yeah. So now again, I'm reverting back. So use first row as header. So as soon as you do that, it detects the change. It detects, as I said, we didn't do anything. Change type one. So it detects, try to detect the data type, and you see here this becomes date data type. So this is point number one, that we have removed rows and we have promoted as headers. Let us try to solve another problem in Excel. So here also we have this two things are considered as header. So let us try to promote it. and Power BI will automatically detect it as data type. Now, here in this case, we need to fill this gap, right? So for that, we have option called fill up or down. In this case, we need to fill down, okay? So sometimes what happens, some totals or grand total, they will put it here only. I mean, all these things belongs to casual wear. In this, if they have data here, we need to fill it up. So in this case, we need to fill it down. So let us go fill down. Okay, now we got the data. You have to understand, for each row you need to have the data. Power BI can't able to understand, since if you filter this one, it should belongs to this category. We need to display based on the column value. That is why we need to fill all these gaps. So these are common Excel related operations. Now in this case, another important problem here is like pivoting and unpivoting. Now what I'm doing, let us try to promote as headers. If you are unpivoting this, you will not get this column. You need to have a column header here, then only you need to go for unpivoting. So that column headers will become the your data. So let us try to promote it. Okay, now this, I want to unpivot. So select the column, okay? Or you can have multiple other columns as well. In this case, I have only one column. Select whatever columns you don't want to unpivot, meaning the columns you want to convert it as rows, just ignore that. Select those do not want to unpivot. Click on this, then unpivot other columns, okay? What happens now? There you go. That is the magic. So for Chennai, you have a budget for 12 months, okay? And for Bangalore, you have starting from January, February, March, you have the data here. Then keep it as month, whatever you want. This is budget. So this is how you need to convert your, transform your data, so that it will fit into Power BI, so that you, the queries you write becomes very less complex. Otherwise, you need to suffer a lot. I hope you guys like this video below for queries. Do remember that data is your asset.